Mr. Chinmay Kundu, 43-year-old gentleman, came to us from a remote village near Kolkata with the plan of having kidney transplantation. He was suffering from a rare familial kidney disease, polycystic kidney disease, and having a kidney failure.
He had huge kidneys occupying most of the part of his tummy and also a rapid deterioration in his clinical condition. He had severe anemia and poor heart condition associated with it, making that his condition even more worse.
मेरा नाम चिन्मय कुंडु, यहाँ इलाज करने के लिए बेंगलोर मणिपाल में आया है। तो यहाँ के फर्स्ट टाइम रवि जगमणि से अपॉइंटमेंट लिया। अपॉइंटमेंट के बाद बोला था दोनों किडनी चेंज करना पड़ेगा।
He was needed kidney transplantation at the earliest.
He had a familial polycystic kidney disease. It is difficult to get a donor from within the family, but luckily his wife came forward for kidney donation.
So this is about Mr. Kundu, who underwent a renal transplant recently. This was one of the most complicated and technically challenging surgeries in kidney transplantation, which perhaps has never been done before anywhere else in this world. The main problem with this patient was his blood vessels in his body were all badly stenosed or blocked. And to transplant a kidney into the body, the blood vessels in the body have to be of a very good quality. But since his blood vessels were bad, we had to think of a way where we could transplant his kidney. And it was made possible because of multiple surgical teams, the cardiac team, the surgical team, the nephrology team, and the ICU team.
This man also had almost total narrowing of his main aorta, just where it was ending, so that there was hardly any blood flow going to both of his legs, and those leg arteries were also diseased. This complicates the whole process of transplantation, where to put the new kidney, give the blood supply to that. Also, somehow if we manage to give the blood supply to the new kidney from some other aspect of the aorta, are we doing the full treatment for him? Because he has got such tight block, even if we make him better kidney wise, he will not be able to walk around and work around because of no blood flow to the leg. So we came up with our own plan. We decided that we will put a bypass graft from his main aorta down to both the legs, and we will take another additional graft from these bypass grafts, put that as the source for the new kidney.
The surgery was done in two stages. In the first stage, the kidneys which were affected, which were very huge, we removed those kidneys and created a space for new transplant kidney. And in the second stage, the blood vessels are repaired by using a synthetic artificial blood channel called synthetic graft, which was used to bypass the damaged aorta and help in restoring the blood supply to the lower part of the body. At this time, I must thank my HOD, Dr. Vishwanath, and my colleague, Dr. Saurabh Kishte, who donated their blood along with me to save the life of a patient and showed their compassion, humanity, and kindness towards patients.
यहाँ का staff, यहाँ का सब कुछ अच्छा लगा मेरे को। अभी operation के बाद सब कुछ normal है, हम अच्छा है, हम चल सकते हैं, walking कर सकते हैं, खाना खा सकते हैं, सब कुछ कर सकते हैं। यहाँ का staff, यहाँ का hospital, यहाँ का doctor अच्छा है।
He almost made a very smooth recovery. His kidney now is working well. He has got very good, nice bounding pulses of his leg. He is able to move around. He has done extremely well, and this again happened in one of the tough times this entire world is facing in the COVID lockdown period. Thanks to Manipal, thanks to all our teams who came together, put in their best expertise so that this poor man could be back on his legs with his normal kidneys.